All right, can y'all see this sweat at 2:30 in the morning? Yes, it's 2:30 in the morning. And why am I sweating, you might ask? Well, RV park doesn't have any power. I have a generator. I turned my generator on. My AC wouldn't work, microwave wouldn't work. Didn't know what it was. Checked all my fuses. My fuses was good. I was like, why isn't my generator running? It ran before, it ran earlier in the day. Why isn't it working? Sitting up, like my fan stopped working. So I was like, you know, I'm gonna try to go to sleep. Couldn't do it. Got on YouTube, typed in generator, RV generator runs, but AC won't work. And lo and behold, this guy's video came up, and guess what? He says there's three reasons that this might be the case. One might be your fuses, right? So of course I had already done that. The second one is a little button, not the startup button that you have on your regular generator, just like at home, not the primer button that you have on your generator, just like at home, but there's a third button that's on the side. So you don't see it when you look at it. And of course they went into other things, carburetors and all that other kind of stuff. It wasn't any of that for me. By the way, I did walk into a spider web out there. So I saw this 2 o'clock in the morning. Now I gotta get dressed, get my tools, my protection, go outside. I'm next to the woods and turn this button, because other than that, I was gonna drive my happy self back on home. I was like, that's it, I'm going home. So I went, got the panel off and everything, flipped that little switch, put the panel back on, did all that stuff, came back inside, turned off one of my air conditioner units to make sure I didn't have too much of a load on a generator, pressed the little button, held it for the 15 seconds, and guess what? The generator is back on and the AC is running. Now mind you, these lights, those were run off the shore power battery. They run off my chassis battery. So they were gonna be on regardless. If those were out, I would have known that it was like the batteries, right? But of course that shouldn't be a case with the generator. My refrigerator runs off propane. So it goes, cycles from one to, there's like three different ways for the refrigerator to run. So that wasn't an indicator. But the microwave and the air conditioning heating system will only work if it's connected to a generator or shore power. It won't run off your battery, it's too much of a load. It won't run off of your house battery, too much of a load. So now that that is done, and by the way, I don't have traditional water. So as much as I'm sweating, this means that I can't even take a shower the way I want to take a shower. And I'm gonna have to go wash my sheets and stuff in the morning. After all of this, I'm gonna have to go wash my sheets and all that because I can't take a shower tonight because I have to wait because of course power's out everywhere and then there was a problem with the water. So I'm using my fresh water tank and I don't wanna use all that up before they get the water restored to us. And so anyway, so if you have any problems, I have found YouTube to be a great place to go, search for videos, and there's lots of people out there who give us the information that we need so that if you're out here doing this nomad life, you can actually do it. I hope this helps somebody.